Hello everyone. In this lecture, we will discuss the concept of spherical coordinates. The conversion of spherical coordinates into rectangular and cylindrical coordinates. Also, we will discuss the evaluation of triple integrals in spherical coordinates. Consider a point P in Cartesian plane with rectangular coordinates x, y, and z. So the spherical coordinates of this point P is given by the ordered triple rho phi theta. Okay. In the last class, we discussed about cylindrical coordinates, which are r theta z. Right. So the spherical coordinates of a point P is rho phi theta. Now what is rho here? Rho is actually the length or distance of this point from the origin O. That is e length aanu ee point evide aano aa pointum originum thammulla distance aanu endu parayunnathu rho ennu parayunnathu the first coordinate rho. Okay, so if the point is here, then the distance will be this, that is rho will be this, etc. Now next, what is phi? The second coordinate phi is the angle between this z axis, that is positive z axis, and this vector OP, that is the line or the vector from origin to P. Okay, so e angle aanu parayunnathu phi ennu parayunnathu. Okay, and theta is actually the same theta defined in the cylindrical coordinates, that is ഇതിനെ ഈ പി എന്ന പോയിന്റിനെ നമ്മൾ എക്സ് വൈ പ്ലെയിനിലേക്ക് പ്രൊജക്ട് ചെയ്യുന്നു. വെക്ടറിനെ നമ്മൾ എക്സ് വൈ പ്ലെയിനിലേക്ക് പ്രൊജക്ട് ചെയ്ത് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ വി വിൽ ഗെറ്റ് ദിസ് ഒ ക്യൂ. ഓക്കെ, ദിസ് ലൈൻ ഒ ക്യൂ വിൽ ഗെറ്റ്. സോ തീറ്റ ഈസ് ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ദ തേർഡ് കോർഡിനേറ്റ്. തീറ്റ ഈസ് ദി ആംഗിൾ ബിറ്റ്വീൻ ദി പോസിറ്റീവ് എക്സ് ആക്സിസ് ആൻഡ് ദിസ് ഒ ക്യൂ. ഓക്കെ, സോ അതാണ് സ്ഫറിക്കൽ കോർഡിനേറ്റ് സിസ്റ്റം, റോ ഫൈ theta. Now equal to a constant, rho equal to a constant ennu parna kanjal and third variables phi and theta can take any value. Rho equal to a constant means phi will be changed. So actually theta can take the value from 0 to 2 pi, 0 to pi. Okay, in that case, if we take this as so if we choose rho equal to a constant, then we will get rho equal to a constant means if this is the point rho, the point P, so rho equal to constant means if rho is a constant, so we will get a sphere like this. Okay, so it will on this sphere it is sphere with the ഒരു സ്ഫിയർ ആയിരിക്കും വിത്ത് റേഡിയസ് സി വൺ. ഓക്കെ, നൗ വാട്ട് ഈസ് ഫൈ ഈക്വൽ ടു എ കോൺസ്റ്റന്റ്? സോ ഫൈ ഈക്വൽ ടു സി ടു മീൻസ് ദാറ്റ് ഈ ആംഗിൾ ഫിക്സ്ഡ് ആണെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ തീറ്റ ക്യാൻ 0 to 2 pi, റോ also can vary from 0 to 2. So we will get a cone like this. Okay, so phi fixed aanu, appo idoru cone, appo aa cone il nammal ivadu ingotte ellanu irikkum, ivadu ivade vera oru point eduthu kanjal avade kanjal phi irikkum, ee cone la ella point ilekkum phi irikkum. So idoru kuda namaku constant phi means phi is a constant c2. Okay, c2 irikkum artham, appo oru cone irikkum kittu. Okay, so it will be a cone. Theta equal to a constant means, so suppose theta equal to a constant, so theta equal to a constant, so theta is this line, ivadnu neyamilla move pattilla, so we will get a plane like this. Okay, so ee plane endayirikkum, ee plane le edhu point eduthu kanjalum aa x axis um, this is the x axis idayirikkum ivada vera, appo aa x axis um aa point nammulla allengil ee kara ee plane um ee point nammulla allengil ee oru point nammulla angle endayirikkum theta irikkum vera, so this is the plane. Okay, so ivada nammal spherical coordinates parayan kaaranam enna vechanal nammude 3D space le edhu point eduthu kanjalum namukku ee moonu സർഫസുകളുടെ ഒരു ഇന്റർസെക്ഷൻ ആയിട്ട് നമുക്ക് ഈ പോയിന്റിനെ കൺസിഡർ ഡിറ്റർമൈൻ ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റും. ഓക്കെ, ഈ മൂന്ന് സർഫസ് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ റോ ഈക്വൽ സി വൺ എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ സർഫസ് ഓഫ് ഓറസ് സ്ഫിയർ. ഓക്കെ, ഫൈ ഈക്വൽ സി ടു എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഇറ്റ്സ് എ കോൺ. ഓക്കെ, ആൻഡ് തീറ്റ ഈക്വൽ സി ത്രീ എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഇറ്റ്സ് എ പ്ലെയിൻ. സോ ആ പ്ലെയിന് ഈ മൂന്ന് സർഫസുകളുടെ ഒരു ഇന്റർസെക്ഷൻ്റെ ഇന്റർസെക്ഷൻ ആയിട്ട് നമുക്ക് എന്ത് ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റും, ഈ പോയിന്റ് പറയാൻ പറ്റും. ഓക്കെ, സോ ഇവിടെ നോക്കാം, ഇവിടെ നമ്മൾ പോയിന്റ് പി എന്ന് എടുത്തു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ വി നോ ദിസ് റോ ഈക്വൽ ടു എ കോൺസ്റ്റന്റ് മീൻസ് വി ഹാവ് ദിസ് ഇസ് ദി റോ ഈക്വൽ ടു എ കോൺസ്റ്റന്റ്, സോ ദിസ് ഇസ് ദി സ്ഫിയർ. ഓക്കെ, സോ ഇവിടെ നമുക്ക് ടു ഡിയിലായിട്ടേ കാണാൻ പറ്റുള്ളൂ, ആക്ച്വലി ഇതൊരു ത്രീ ഡി സ്ഫിയർ ആണ്. സോ വിത്ത് ഇവിടെ ആ സ്ഫിയറിന്റെ ബൗണ്ടറിയിൽ ഏതൊരു പോയിന്റ് എടുത്തു കഴിഞ്ഞാലും നമുക്ക് അവിടെ തമ്മിലുള്ള റോ ഡിസ്റ്റൻസ് ഫ്രം ഒറിജിൻ എന്തായിരിക്കും, റോ ആയിരിക്കും. ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് റോ മീൻസ് കോൺസ്റ്റന്റ് എത്രയാണോ ആ കോൺസ്റ്റന്റ് ആയിരിക്കും. ഓക്കെ, സോ അതൊരു സ്ഫിയർ ആണ്. ഇവിടെ നമ്മൾ കോൺ എന്ന് പറയുമ്പോൾ ഇതാണ് ആ കോൺ, തീറ്റ ഈക്വൽ ടു ദിസ് ഇസ് ആക്ച്വലി ഫൈ ഈക്വൽ ടു എ കോൺസ്റ്റന്റ്. ഓക്കെ, ഫൈ ഈക്വൽ ടു എ കോൺസ്റ്റന്റ്, സോ ദിസ് ഇസ് എ കോൺസ്റ്റന്റ് സി ടു. ഓക്കെ, സോ ദിസ് ലൈൻ, ദിസ് ഇസ് ഈ ഒരു കോൺ ആയിരിക്കും എന്ത് പറയുന്നത്, ദിസ് ഇസ് ഫൈ ഈക്വൽ ടു സി ടു. ഈ കോണ് അതും എന്ത് ചെയ്യുന്നത്, ഈ പോയിന്റിലൂടെയാണ് ആയിരിക്കും പാസ് ചെയ്യുന്നുണ്ടാവുക ആ കോണ്. ഓക്കെ, അതായത് ഈ ഒരു പോയിന്റ് എന്നുള്ള കോണിലെ ഒരു പോയിന്റ് ആയിരിക്കും. നെക്സ്റ്റ് തീറ്റ ഈക്വൾ കോൺസ്റ്റന്റ് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ദിസ് ഇസ് ദി ആംഗിൾ തീറ്റ ഈക്വൾ ടു കോൺസ്റ്റന്റ് സി ത്രീ. ഓക്കെ, സോ ദിസ് ഇസ് ദി പ്ലെയിൻ. സോ ഈ പോയിന്റ് കറസ്പോണ്ടിങ് ആയിട്ട് എടുത്തു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ നമുക്ക് ഇങ്ങനെ എഴുതാൻ പറ്റും. സോ ഇൻ സ്ഫെറിക്കൽ കോർഡിനേറ്റ്സ് എനി പോയിന്റ് പി ഇൻ ത്രീ ഡി സ്പേസ് ക്യാൻ ബി ഡിറ്റർമൈൻഡ് ബൈ ദി ഇന്റർസെക്ഷൻ ഓഫ് a cone phi equal to a constant, a plane theta equal to constant, and a sphere rho equal to a constant. Okay, appo by using this adondana spherical coordinates nu peru varan kaaranam edru space 3d 3d space le edru point le namaku idu ivagalde oru intersection aakite namaku ezhudan pattum artham. Okay, ipo rho ennalle nammal fix cheyidu, suppose rho equal to some 2. Okay, and phi ennalladhu njan endeyunu, phi varies from 0 to pi, and theta varies from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, ingane cheythu kanjal namukku endu kittum, rho equal to 2 nu paranjal, suppose this is rho. Okay, this is 2, this length is 2. Okay, so this length is 2 suppose, and idu fix cheythu kanju, then theta phi varies from 0 to pi, that is vary this phi from 0 to pi slightly like this. Okay, appo ee oru point namukku ividam vare vary cheyikkan pattum, appo namukku endu kittum, idu oru ee line katti, appo idu ivide vary cheyichu kanjal namukku ithrayum katti. Okay, so if you are taking rho is less than or equal to 2, so it will contain these points, rho equal to these points. Okay, and if you are varying phi from 0 to pi, so it will contain all these points, that is we will get a hemi disk or semi disk, right? Okay, now if we are varying theta from 0 to 2 pi, so theta from 0 to 2 pi means this semi disk or half disk can be vary from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, so an entire sphere, right? So we'll get an entire sphere with the radius 2. Okay, so we'll get so this rho is less than or equal to 2, that is rho varies from 0 to 2, phi varies from 0 to pi, and theta varies from 0 to 2 pi, will get a sphere of center to origin and radius 2. Okay, next, conversion of spherical coordinates to rectangular and cylindrical coordinates. So suppose we have the spherical coordinates rho, phi, theta. Then we can convert this spherical coordinate into rectangular coordinates x, y, z by using this formula. X is equal to rho sine phi cos theta, y equal to rho sine phi sine theta, and z is equal to rho cos phi. Okay, by using this conversion, we can convert this spherical coordinates into rectangular coordinates. Now, to convert this spherical coordinates into cylindrical coordinates r, theta, z, we can use this. R equal to rho sine phi, theta equal to theta itself, no change in theta, and z is equal to rho cos phi. Okay. Now, conversion of rectangular coordinates to spherical coordinates. So that is, suppose we have the rectangular coordinates x, y, z. Now, to convert this into the spherical coordinates rho, phi, theta, we can use this formula. That is, rho square is equal to x square plus y square plus z square. Okay. Tan theta equal to y by x, and cos phi equal to z by square root of x square plus y square plus z square. So phi equal to cos inverse of this, theta equal to tan inverse of y by x, and rho equal to square root of x square plus y square plus z square. Okay. So actually, x square plus y square plus z square is equal to rho square is s rho. Okay. So we have an example. 6 pi by 4 pi by 3 in spherical coordinates to rectangular coordinates and cylindrical coordinates. So we are given that this is rho phi theta. That is, we are given the coordinates, that is spherical coordinates. So we have rho equal to 6, phi equal to pi by 4, and theta equal to pi by 3. So by using this conversion formula, we can find the rectangular and corresponding rectangular coordinates and cylindrical coordinates. So we have to convert into rectangular coordinates, we have x is equal to rho sine phi cos theta. So by using these values of rho, phi, and theta, we have rho equal to 6, sin pi by 4, because phi equal to pi by 4, into cos pi by 3. Okay, so we have this is equal to 6 into sin pi by 4 is 1 by root 2, into cos pi by 3 is 1 by 2. So this is equal to 3 by root 2. Okay, that is 3 root 2 by 2, that is 3 by root 2. Okay, so now y equal to the second coordinate y equal to rho into sin phi sin theta. So replacing this rho, phi, and theta, we get 6 sin pi by 4 into sin theta, or sin pi by 3. So we have this is nothing but 6 into sin pi by 4 is 1 by root 2 into sin pi by 3 is root 3 by 2. So this is nothing but 3 root 3 by root 2. Right. To obtain this answer, you just multiply the numerator and denominator with the root 2. Okay. Next, the third coordinate z is equal to rho cos phi. So this is nothing but rho is 6 and phi is pi by 4. So this is equal to 6 into cos pi by 4. So which is equal to 6 into cos pi by 4 is 1 by root 2. Okay. Here also, to get this 3 root 2, you just we can multiply and divide by root 2. So we'll get 6 by 2, that is 3 root 2. Okay. So this is the z. So the corresponding rectangular coordinates are 3 root 2 by root 2, 3 root 6 by 2, 3 root 2. X, y, z is equal to this. Okay. Now, to convert this spherical coordinates into cylindrical coordinates, we know to convert into cylindrical coordinates r, theta, z. Okay, we have the conversion formula. R equal to rho sine phi, which is equal to 6 into sine pi by 4, so it is equal to 3/2, and theta equal to theta, so we have theta equal to pi by 3 itself, and z is equal to rho cos phi, so which is nothing but 6 into cos pi by 4, which is 3/2. Okay, so we have the corresponding cylindrical coordinates 3/3/2, pi by 3, 3/2. Okay, next, how to evaluate triple integrals in spherical coordinates. Okay, so to evaluate this triple integral in spherical coordinates, we have to replace dx dy dz, that is dv, by rho square sine phi d rho d phi d theta. Okay, in the case of cylindrical coordinates, we have dv is equal to r dr or dr dz dr d theta. Okay, in the case of spherical coordinates, we have dv can be replaced by rho square sine phi d rho d phi d theta. Clear? So the integral, triple integral over d f of rho phi theta dv can be written as integral theta from alpha to beta, that is the variations of alpha theta, and second is for phi, so phi from g1 theta to g2 theta, and rho from f1 phi theta equal to f2 phi theta, f of rho phi theta into dv, and dv can be replaced by this, so that is rho square sin phi d rho d phi d theta. Okay, so to convert a triple integral f of x y z dv into spherical coordinate, we have to replace the corresponding formula for x, y, z, and dv can be replaced by this. Okay, that means, that is, to convert this triple integral in rectangular coordinates, we can use these formulae, that is, we can replace x by rho sin phi cos theta, y by rho sin phi sin theta, and z by rho cos phi. Also, dv by this rho square sin phi d rho d phi d theta. Okay, and we have to convert this limits of the integrals for x, y, and z into the variations of limits of theta, phi, and rho. Okay, so as an example, we can do this. Find the moment of inertia about the z axis of the homogeneous solid bounded between the spheres x square plus y square plus z square equal to a square, and x square plus y square plus z square equal to b square, where a is less than b. So here we need to find the moment of inertia about the z axis. Okay, that is, we need to find I z, okay, of this solid which is bounded between the spheres x square plus y square plus z square equal to a square. This is the sphere with the radius a, and this is a sphere with the radius b, but we are given that a is less than b. So we have two spheres, and the inner sphere is with radius a, and the outer sphere is with radius b. Okay, so our solid is our region is actually the this part. Okay, this is actually a solid, it's a difference of these two spheres. Okay, so how to find this moment of inertia of this solid bounded by these two our spheres? Okay, now we have the equation for the moment of inertia, which is nothing but we have moment of inertia is equal to about z axis is equal to triple integral over d x square plus y square into density is rho. So here actually we already used rho in this equation, so we can take the density as delta. Okay, delta into dv. Okay, so here we are not given what is density, so we are taking supposing this k is the density of the solid. Okay, so if delta equal to k is the density, then we have the moment of inertia about z axis of the solid d. D is actually part of this sphere, that is the solid between these two spheres. Okay, so x square plus y square into that moment density into dv, that is the equation of the moment of inertia. So here we have the density is k, so we have x square plus y square into k dv. Okay, now our aim is to find this triple integral, that will be our moment of inertia. Since our region of integration d is a part of the sphere, it will be more convenient to convert this integral into spherical coordinates. Okay, so to convert into spherical coordinate, we have to replace x by rho sin phi cos theta, y by rho sin phi sin theta, and z by rho cos phi. And dv can be replaced by this rho square sin phi d rho d phi and d theta. Okay, so when we replace x by this and y by this, we get x square plus y square. As we know, x square plus y square plus z square is equal to rho square, right? So from this we have x square plus y square is equal to rho square minus z square. So we have z is equal to rho cos phi, so this is equal to rho square minus z square is rho square into cos square phi by from this. So this is equal to rho square into 1 minus cos square phi. 1 minus cos square phi is nothing but sin square phi. So rho square into sin square phi. So we can replace x square plus y square by rho square into sin square phi. Okay. Or you will get this by directly substituting x by this and y by this. Okay. So our required integral is for the moment of inertia is nothing but iz is equal to double integral over d x square plus y square, triple integral over d x square plus y square k dv. So we have to we can replace this x square plus y square by rho square into sin square phi, and dv k is here, we can take k outside, and dv can be replaced by this. Clear? So now we have to find the variations of phi, rho and theta. So this is our required region. Okay, this part of this sphere is the required region. So actually this red shaded region is, or red shaded sphere is x square plus y square plus z square equal to a square. That is, this is a sphere with radius a. Okay, and this is a sphere with the radius b. Okay, here we are given that x square plus y square plus z square equal to b square, and this is a square, so a is less than b. So inner sphere is with the radius a and the outer sphere is with the radius b. So we have to eliminate this portion. Okay, so we need only this blue shaded region. Okay, so what about the variations? So rho is varies from this to this. Okay, so rho varies from here to here or this to here. So this is actually rho equal to a. So rho varies from a to b. Clear? That the outer sphere is with this radius b. So rho varies from a to b. Now theta varies from, or phi varies from, phi is, we know phi is the angle between the between the positive z axis and the point. So the point, that means the vector, the position vector of the point. So we need this sphere. Okay, so we can take phi varies from 0 to pi. So we will get, actually we will get this part. Okay, this type of part we'll get. And then theta varies from 0 to this is theta varies from 0 to 2 pi. So we will complete this sphere excluding this this inner sphere, because we are taking the values or the variations of rho from a to b. So we are excluding this inner sphere. Okay, so from by using these variations we will get our required region. Okay, so we have our integral is nothing but this is with respect to rho from a to b, then phi from 0 to pi, and theta from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, So integrating this, so this is nothing but rho square into rho square is rho power 4 sine cube theta. Here is sine phi, sine phi. So sine cube phi d rho d phi d theta. So this is equal to k into integral 0 to 2 pi, that is theta from 0 to 2 pi. Then and phi from 0 to pi, we have to integrate with respect to rho first. So we can take sine cube phi outside. So integral rho from a to b, rho power 4 d rho, then d phi, then b theta. Okay, so integrating this inner integral with respect to rho, we get rho power 5 divided by 5, and here sine cube of phi is a constant with respect to rho. So we have to replace the values of rho from b a to b. So this is b power 5 divided minus a power 5 will be here into k by 5 will be a constant. So the remaining integral will be integral from theta from 0 to pi, phi from 0 to pi, sine cube phi d phi d theta. Okay, so sine cube phi can be written as, this is equal to we have this into sine cube phi can be written as sine square phi into sine phi, and sine square phi can be written as 1 minus cos square phi into sine phi. Okay, so we can replace this sine cube phi by 1 minus cos square phi into sine phi d phi d theta. This is, we are done this to integrate this. So now we can replace this cos phi by some new variable u. So taking u or putting u equal to some cos phi, we get du is equal to minus sine phi d phi. Okay, so here we have to integrate this. So sine phi d phi is here. So sine phi d phi is equal to minus du. So we can write this integral as, so for convenience I'm taking to here. So this is equal to, this integral is nothing but by using this substitution, we have some k by 5 into b power 5 minus a power 5 into integral theta from 0 to 2 pi, then and phi from 0 to pi. I am using this with respect to u, with respect to phi also only. Then 1 minus cos square, that is 1 minus u square into sine phi d phi is nothing but minus du. So this is equal to a minus can be put here, minus du into d theta. Okay, so we are integrating this with respect to u. We'll get this is this integrals will be u minus uq by 3 from phi is equal to 0 to pi. So replacing phi here, phi is nothing but cos phi, u is nothing but cos phi. So this is cos phi minus cos cube phi divided by 3 from phi equal to 0 to pi. So by using this negative, we will get minus cos phi plus cos cube phi divided by 3, that is this minus cos phi plus cos q phi divided by 3 from 0 to pi, phi from 0 to pi d theta, and this is the we are taken outside. So applying this limit, we will get negative of cos pi is minus 1. We will get here, applying this limit, we will get cos pi is minus 1. So 1 minus minus plus cos phi is 0, cos 0 is 1, that is 1. So plus 1 by 3 into cos cube phi minus cos cube 0. So cos phi is minus 1. So we have cos pi is minus 1. So cos cube phi is minus 1 minus cos 0 is 1. So cos cube 0 is also, that's 1 cube. Okay. So we'll have this. The value of this is 2. That is equal to 2 minus 2 by 3, that is 6 minus 2, that is 4 by 3, right? So we have multiplied here 4 by 3 in the next step. So 4 by 3 into 5 is 15. Okay, so the remaining part is integral 0 to 2 pi d theta only, because this is a constant, that is that constant was 4 by 6, that is 4 by 3 we have multiplied here. Okay, so this is nothing but 2 pi. So Integrating this, we get theta from 0 to 2 pi. So this is 2 pi. So 4k by 15 v power 5 minus 5 minus a power 5 into 2 pi, that is 8 pi k divided by 15 into b power 5 minus a power 5. Okay, that would be the moment of inertia about z axis. Clear? Yeah.